From the very start, Total Feeds has used the best ingredients to create a product that will enhance the total health and performance of any animal you have at any stage of their life. And Total Feeds doesn't stop at products for your animals. Total People Plus was designed to make sure that you stay healthy as well. Good evening and welcome to Rural America Live. I'm Christina Loren. Thank you so much for joining us. Tonight we have Dr. Harry Anderson with us, owner and founder of Total Feeds. Thanks for joining us, Dr. Anderson.
Great to be here again, Christina. I love this time together.
Oh, you know what? Our viewers certainly love it. It shows up in the ratings, that's for sure. Yeah, it is. Now, you've been a busy man over the past few months. You've been rolling out more and more of the Rodeo Roundtable. Yeah. Talk about that.
Well, the Rodeo Roundtable is going over really well, and it's just kind of fun to watch those little funny things that these people do, and they all support us while they're doing it, but they entertain and kind of help people understand our products all at the same time, and we're going to be doing those for a long time, I think.
Absolutely.
Every Wednesday night, 8 o'clock, social media, and especially they go up on our YouTube, and there's no excuse for anybody not finding them.
And you know, you can watch it. If you can't make it to the live performance, you actually have chances to watch the archive like you're talking about. Now, for those who may be unfamiliar, let's take a look at what Rodeo Roundtable is all about.
I was wearing boy shorts, thank the Lord.
Ayo.
I wasn't sure if you said chick roping or chicken roping.
Are you done too?
She's done.
It's just us three.
I'm betting $60.
I thought those was worth 20.
But you're wrong.
Some big names you were able to pull together.
But this is the way they get along, you know, they all know each other so well, they can just banter back and forth, ad lib.
Give it to one another as well.
That's right.
Now, okay, let's talk about Total Equine.
Yes.
This is where it all started for you, and you've really had an excellent response from the ranching community. I understand one of your clients had a horse that was overweight and struggling to walk. Tell us about that.
Yes, this is Marilee Gable. She's from Mississippi, and I've worked with Marilee for several years now on getting Cheyenne to where he is today. But when we first started working together, I didn't realize what we were dealing with exactly. But Cheyenne, if we go back about 7 years ago, he was 15 years old, and he was in a riding school where they did riding schools. And the riding instructor could no longer take care of him or couldn't own him. So they elected to purchase him, partly because he had bonded with their 8-year-old boy. The instructor actually told Marilee that this horse would do things for Jeremy, the 8-year-old boy, that he could not get him to do. And so they kind of fell in love with this old horse. He wasn't old at that time, but he was overweight. He had a crusty neck when they brought him home. He was borderline Cushing's, partially trained, not fully trained, and was very unmanageable because he'd always been in a very controlled environment, and he knew in that environment he did certain things and he'd walk with people. And they were using a curb bit on him, and they were controlling him with power, you know, instead of finesse, power. And when they figured out, when he figured out, they took him outside, and when he was kind of free and open, they couldn't control him.
Oh.
So about 6 months in, she went to a Chris Cox clinic, which was a smart thing to do. And when she was at Chris Cox's clinic, he helped her with some management things on Cheyenne, but also taught her about Total Feeds products and programs. She went home, started him on Total Equine, and for several years, they were doing quite well by some controlled grazing and things like that, and he was getting along just fine on Total Equine. And then along about, let's see, it was in 2 years ago, in 2017, in April, he started showing signs of being a little bit lame.
Oh, my goodness.
And not only did he get lame, but he showed up like we're seeing right now. And so she couldn't figure out what was going on. That's when she took him to Mississippi State. And Mississippi State, he did some corrective shoeing, changed some shoeing on him. A doctor, Neighbors did that, Ben Neighbors. But he also said, now, you've got mild Cushing's, you have to be careful with that. He needs to lose about 200 pounds. And he has a low thyroid. So what he did, he was going to put him on Thyroid L, which is a thyroid stimulator. But Marilee went home and started him out on 1/3 of a dose, a small dose of this, and he became very aggressive. She backed that right out and said no more. That's when she called me, and that's when I'm going to let Marilee pick up the story and tell how it progressed from there and how we did this with Cheyenne.
And we got the essentials, and Dr. Harry Anderson had told us, he said it's recommended to feed at 1 pound per day, but he says to accelerate the process, since he needs to lose weight, we're going to do 2 pounds. And then he told me to start him out at about 6 pounds of hay and then just slowly take it away. You know, he says as long as he's not crabby, just keep taking it away. Well, I just started him out at 3 pounds and he wasn't crabby, so that's where I kept him. But in 2 days, the lameness went away and he started walking without medication. And it was just amazing. And so then at 4 weeks, I took him back for another shoeing. And Dr. Neighbors had told me, he said, it's probably gonna be a little rough, you know. He's gonna be sore, trailering, you know, 300 mile round trip. And I brought him home, never gave him any butte, kept him on his diet of essentials and his little bit of hay. And he, 2 days after the shoeing, he was just a walking around just like nobody's business. And it's just, he lost 76 pounds in 4 weeks, which Dr. Neighbors thought that was very amazing. He weighed in at 1393 when I took him. Mm-hmm. So we're 76 pounds is, we're getting there. Yeah. He just continued to progress. We walked him for a few days. Wasn't long, we asked for a jog. And we just kept progressing him. And by, I think it was August, I wasn't cantering him yet, but he would canter on his own in the pasture. And in about September, I think, he finally reached his goal weight. So he lost his, he actually lost just a little over 200 pounds in 3.5 months. And in March of last year, we're right about at a year now. And when I wanted to sign up for this clinic, I called Dr. Neighbors and I said, what do you think? Is it going to be too much for him? And he says, well, as long as the terrain's not too bad. And I says, well, I think that'll be fine. We've been there before. It won't be any different than how we ride him at home. He says, well, as far as I'm concerned, you're cleared to go. And one thing he did tell me when I brought him, he said his feet were grotesquely, just really deformed. Like some of it was weight problem. Some of it was our farrier didn't really understand foot balance. And so he had really, really long toes. He was down on his heels, flat soles. And so his feet were really large and ugly as far as misshapen. And he said his white lines were stretched an inch wide when I brought him in. And today they are closed back up to what's normal, and he says 1 foot is even a little narrower than what is normal as far as the white line, as tight as it is, which is just amazing to me. And once we took him off of, once he reached his weight, ideal weight, then we changed him to the LNSC. And so now we feed him, we started out at 5 pounds a day, but with the hay situation not being all that great this year, we're giving him 9 pounds a day with just a tiny bit of hay, and he's really doing well.
And you can see how well he's doing. What a transformation.
Yeah, Cheyenne is a great horse. He's a big, very muscular horse, so we're really excited about him, bringing him back. But Marilee touched on quite a few things here. One is that the founder, if even of unknown origin, can be corrected with nutritional help and trimming. Now, Dr. Neighbors was very important in this process. He trimmed the horse properly, got the toe shortened up, and they brought the heel up so he could walk correctly. But then we helped it grow out into a normal textured hoof. And like she was talking about, the white line was so wide, it was a bad white line problem. And that has been corrected too. And all of that hoof just grows out normally. And over the time she was talking about, that's about how fast these hoofs will totally change over.
That's so impressive to me. And especially, right. I'm sure a lot of people may think that there's no hope for their horse dealing with the same issue.
This horse was at a point where a lot of people would have been seriously considered putting him down instead of trying to fight through this thing. Mm-hmm. Because a lot of times this is a year's process to getting this back. You heard how quickly he responded. She said 2 weeks and he was moving normal again. Just based on essentials. And what it shows is that there is a place for my secondary products, the LNSA and,
yes,
and the essentials. The essentials is the most extreme one that we would use for losing weight. And if you figure that out, in 105 days, he lost over 200 pounds, 2 pounds a day all the way through. And the other thing is how little feed they can get by with. Here's a good lesson on how many calories there are in fat. He was eating 2 pounds of essentials. That's about 2,000 calories. He was eating 3 pounds of hay. That's about 2,700 calories. That amounted to less than 3,000 calories he was taking in per day. Wow. He was happy. She said he was happy with that. There's 3,500 calories or 7,000 calories that he was pulling off the outside of his body using his energy. That's why he was comfortable. That's why, folks, if you're going to get them to lose weight, don't feel sorry for them.
Yeah.
They have plenty. If they're burning fat, that's 3,500 calories for every pound of fat they give up. They can live on that for quite a while.
It's easier on their organs. They will perform better.
Exactly. And then the thyroid activity. I run into so many horses that are on something like Thyro-L that to stimulate thyroid activity. Mm-hmm. We already do that, as evidenced by what she was talking about. That speeded up the metabolic activity so that they will burn the fat. They will have the more energy if you allow them the right nutrients to keep that thyroid as active as it needs to be. Then And the other thing is the low amount of feed. If you ask most anybody how a horse that weighs 12 to 1,400 pounds, somewhere in that range, can get by on 2 pounds of supplement and 3 pounds of hay, that's 5 total pounds of feed. That's less than 0.5% of the body weight. That's just barely over 1/3% of the body weight. Most people will say horses have to eat 2% of body weight.
Do they?
Not true. It depends on the situation.
Yeah.
But we're just so proud of that. And then she didn't mention so much about the salt intake here, but that was very critical in the whole thing. When he was not feeling well or eating well, she started giving him some different kinds of salt to see what he wanted. Nothing worked well until she gave some Redmond salt. Now, I'm not a Redmond salt salesman, and I get nothing out of this, but Redmond salt, there's some special properties to that if you, because it has some micro trace minerals that came from the bottom of an old ocean. And so it has some very important micro trace minerals that help everything go along. And then she also, she does use the one joint product that I recommend, and Lubricin was an important part of this whole process. So it wasn't just one thing. It wasn't just my formula or just wasn't Dr. Neighbors. It was a combination. It was a whole program that we put together for Cheyenne, and we're just excited that it worked.
Absolutely, and I'm sure a lot of people who are watching right now are excited about the potential for their animals as well. And we actually get to talk to Brandi Stevenson now. She joins us on the line. She's very familiar with the Total Feeds line of products. Brandi, thanks for joining us.
Oh, thanks for having me.
Hi, Brandi.
Hi, Dr. Harry. How are you?
I'm good. How are things in Alaska?
Oh, it's starting to thaw out. We're excited that winter's getting over.
I heard in a song one time that when it's springtime in Alaska, it's 40 below. Is that true?
Oh, maybe if you go up to Bell, but not quite as far south as we are.
That was an old Furland Husky song. You're too young to remember that. But, Brandy, briefly, I'd like to have you tell us the story about the gray horse that you sent a picture of. Tell us who that is and how that kind of looked and what took place with that horse.
Okay, so we've got a big gray mare, and she's 36 years old, and she's got a heart murmur, so it's very difficult to do her teeth. She doesn't have much for teeth left, and she can only eat soft food. So she weighs about 1,300 pounds right now, and we give her 4 pounds of total equine and then supplement her with some alfalfa pellets. But we've seen just, her top line's great. She has muscle mass. She walks anywhere from about 4 to 6 miles a day. They're just turned out in pasture right now in the winter. But, you know, she still gets up, trots around. We get 25, 30 below here in the winter, you know, and we had a little bit of a cold snap, and we haven't had a blanket on this mare, nothing. She's grown up in this country, so.
That's great. And we have a little video of a horse much older than that that I'd like you to tell us a little about. This 40-plus-year-old horse, did you ever figure out how much over 40 she is?
You know, they told me they quit counting as soon as he hit 40. They just decided that was old enough.
Tell me about the feeding program on this horse.
Okay, so this horse, he was in really bad shape. He had an abscess tooth. When they'd feed him, they fed him as much hay as he wanted, and he would just spit out these hay wads, and they have him on 8 pounds total equine, nothing else.
Okay. Now, Brandy, that's real important. It, as cold as it gets in Alaska, I've been told by people that a horse has to have a lot of hay to keep warm in the wintertime, but why isn't he freezing to death?
You know, I guess he's just getting what he needs.
There you go. Yeah. This is a great lesson, Brandy, and I thank you for this, because it's so important to understand that our program works in that kind of a climate, as well as in the southern climate where it hardly ever gets cold. So I thank you a lot. You have a great time and stay in touch, would you please?
Yes, sir. All right.
Thank you, Brandy. Wow, that horse was really moving, too,
well,
for
yeah.
a 40-year-old horse.
Uh-huh. Hadn't slowed up any.
You know, we want to hear from Dawn, because your products work for all breeds, like you said, all hemispheres. Let's talk to Dawn Brandon. She joins us now on the phone to share her story of success. Thanks for joining us. Go right ahead.
Hi, good evening. Thanks for having me.
How's Dawn? How are things in Missouri?
Oh, it's good. We're thawing out as well.
Yeah,
so
I know.
Everything is raining up. We're getting happy here.
Yeah. Well, Dawn, tell me a little bit about your program. You raise Clydesdales, and I know
you've used
it for quite a while. How does it work on the big old Clydesdales?
It works just as well as on my quarter horses. I mean, they take in a little more, but I mean, I think the thing that I have noticed the most about your feed is that my horses are proportionate in their bodies. They're not all hay belly. They're not all crusty necks. Everybody is proportionate and puts on the muscle, the top line, grows well.
And we've got a picture of Remington up on the screen right now. Tell me about Remington. He's 6 months old, I guess.
He is 6 months old. He's a pistol. His mom was on it, of course, right from the beginning, and I think that's why he's turned out to be such a nice horse. He was born looking as, like I say, proportionate. He was not a skinny little wing, skinny little foal at all, and he has filled out eating his total equine with mom, and, of course, mom's nursing and everything. She gets what she wants, but he started eating it right with her when he could, and he's been on it ever since, and he's currently at 14 hands.
Okay.
And so,
that's great. Well, Dawn, I appreciate that very much, and we love to see the picture of those. So we'll see you down the road.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
What a great picture, and just to see what great shape that little guy was in. How tall would you say that little Clydesdale was?
14 hands.
You can't
That's
tell.
That's 56 inches.
You cannot tell by just looking at that picture. What
he
a
will
beauty.
Mature somewhere around 18 to 19 hands.
Wow.
Which is 72 to 78 inches.
And they're starting them out bright with Total Equine.
You bet.
I love it.
Absolutely.
Okay, well, we have so much to cover tonight. We want to thank you so much for joining us. We're going to talk a little bit more about Total Equine, Total Bull, and the other products that we have with Total Feeds. We got Dr. Anderson with us for a full hour tonight. Stay with us. More Rural America Live right after this. Plus, we're going to be taking your phone calls after this quick break. 877-731-6733 is the number to call. You can talk to Dr. Anderson directly. Share your success stories. Ask your questions. More Rural America Live with Total Feeds right after this. 877-731-6733. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Rural America Live. I'm Christina Loren. The best ingredients possible are at the core of Total Feeds products. Joining us tonight is Dr. Harry Anderson, owner and founder of Total Feeds. And remember, you're a big part of the show. We want to hear from you tonight. Call in with your questions for Dr. Anderson or even share your stories of success with Total Feeds. The number to call is 877-731-6733. Grab a pen and jot it down so you can give us a call, 877-731-6733. We're going to go to the phones in just a moment, but Dr. Anderson, you learned from studying cells, and a big reason why your products are so successful is absorption. Talk about how that works.
This is very, very critical to our program, and what I want to show tonight and talk you through a little bit about the absorption of trace minerals. That's the key to what I feel is our big success. Now, if you look at this, you'll see that on the upper part of that stomach, there are four big green dots. And just below that are some pinker dots that have some formulas in them. Well, the green dots are simply minerals that are commonly used in the feed industry, and they're made up with oxides or sulfates, what we call the metals. And when we talk about metals, the metal is the mineral, like what magnesium or copper or zinc or whatever it is. And it's attached to something like oxygen or sulfate. And that's what we've used forever. And the pink ones are more of the proteinates, which are the minerals attached to a piece of a protein or an amino acid or something like that. And those all enter the stomach up there the way they're put in chemically. And as they move down to the bottom of the stomach, the acidity gets very, very strong down there, and all of a sudden it breaks them apart. Now we just have the zinc metal or the calcium metal or whatever metal all by itself that's looking for something to react with. And if you notice, there's a little dot all by itself over there, kind of pink, and down toward the bottom left on the screen is the amino acid chelate that we use. It's not reacted when it gets to the bottom. It's still intact. And as they move into the small intestine, which is the duodenum, that's still very acidic back there. And what these minerals do that are all by themselves, they have to attach to a carrier protein that actually takes them in through the intestinal wall. And that first part, the duodenum, is only about 6 or 7 feet long in a horse. And so they have to be released and absorbed in that period of time. If they're on a feed that doesn't dissolve, they're not released. Oh. And they're carried on down the track a little further, which I'll show you what happens. But the ones that are available there, they attach to this carrier protein, they go through the intestinal wall, and this is the only part of the intestine those minerals are going to get absorbed in. Huh. But look at the little pink one up there in the middle. It hasn't reacted yet. And all the metals are going on in, and they're starting to react with different compounds in the intestinal tract as the acidity gets less and the pH goes up. And so they're suddenly attached to things that cannot be absorbed, and they're carried right out the back end of the animal. Oh. They're not used by the animal. But that little one, that little pink one down there, you see how it's going down toward the intestinal wall? Yep. That is still intact. It is absorbed through that part of the stomach, intact, as an amino acid chelate. And so it's very, very efficient in getting it in there. And that's why animals or people on my program always have adequate blood levels of trace minerals, and their blood profiles are good. And so the chelate, very little, if any, ever goes down the tract and gets out the back side of the animal and gets wasted.
Without
so I know you don't have to be a chemist to understand this, right?
Not when you explain it.
But it just makes sense if you see the chemistry and how it works, or why the amino acid chelate that we use is so effective in the absorption and the utilization. And that's why in total feeds, when we extrude this product, it also dissolves immediately in that area, so everything is available.
You know what's great is I love how you always bring the science behind why your products work. You're not just hearing the testimonials. You're not just hearing us talk about it. You show the science behind it, and I love that, and I know a lot of people do as well. In fact, we're getting some calls in already. Jamie from Wyoming, you are up to bat first tonight. Thanks for joining the conversation. Go right ahead. You're on with Dr. Anderson.
Okay. Hello, Dr. Anderson. We have a ranch in Wyoming, and we have several horses, and we use them pretty heavily. And we have a 9-year-old quarter horse that we feed our horses grass hay with some alfalfa, and we just can't put any weight on this horse at all. And I'm wondering if, you know, you have something that we have total equine, but I don't know if we're not feeding him right amounts of it, but we'd like to get some weight put on this horse.
Okay, well, the thing that you need to, I don't know how much you're feeding per day, but if you're feeding grass hay, and to some of these horses, they need a little higher protein than what comes in grass hay. Two things I would recommend. If you're only feeding 4 pounds a day, I would go to like 8 pounds a day for 30 days. And then in the meantime, I would get a hold of some alfalfa hay or alfalfa pellets, or just and give 3 or 4 pounds, maybe 5 pounds of those along with the total equine, and give that 30 days, and I think you'll see a dramatic change in this horse because of the increased quality protein intake.
Excellent. Thank you so much for that call, Jamie. We appreciate that. We're going to go back to the phones in just a moment, but let's talk a little bit about Total Canine, another one of your popular products.
Canine is one of our fun products to talk about because we're getting more and more enthusiastic people out there using it and giving us feedback and telling us how it's helping skin problems, it's helping old age joint problems, and just attitude, stamina is improving, all of these things that they're telling us about. And we do have one specific story from Jackie Moss in Oklahoma, and Jackie had this heeler, a red heeler, that is 13 years old. I shouldn't say was, and in those 13 years, they've tried every kind of dog food that there is to keep her from scratching. They said she was scratched all the time, day and night, and so my dealer, Donnie Gang, gave her a bag of Total Canine to try. So she went home and fed that bag, and she said after feeding one bag of Total Canine, the Roxanne is done itching on her coat and is very, very thick, and she's not rolling and scratching all the time like she used to. And she said she won't feed anything else. She's really comfortable, and she sleeps through the night again, and she said we all do.
Wow, you know,
because Roxanne isn't scratching.
It's amazing. It just works for such a myriad of issues that our dogs, you know, our dogs are our family members just like our horses are.
Exactly.
So it's just wonderful when you can help your animal. They can't talk. They can't tell you what's going on. But when you can give them one product that heals them in multiple ways, I mean, why not go for it?
That's right.
You know what I love as well? There's no age limit. You can give it to a puppy. You can give it to a senior dog.
Exactly. Just ask Bert.
You know, you also have Bert and Franny Davis like you're talking about. Now, Bert has quite a history in rodeo.
Oh, yeah. He's an old rodeo clown, bullfighter, et cetera, barrel man.
Let's hear what Bert has to say.
Actually, we have an 11-month-old standard poodle that we started on Total Canine when she was 8 weeks old. We didn't put water in it or not because I asked the breeder, you know, do you moisten your food for the puppies? She goes, they got sharp teeth, let them eat it. So she started eating Total Canine at 8 weeks old, and she's been on it. She's just turned 11 months old, and she gets breakfast and dinner of Total Canine, and she loves it. And if I would have known poodles would have looked like that and her disposition, I'd own a lot more.
Tell me a little bit about how you get your puppy dogs.
Mainly our dogs are rescues. Either their owner surrenders or they are, we find them in a shelter. And we have a couple strays that made a love connection. And then we have our Born to Perform program. So this year, in our 10 dog act, there are four new ones that we're utilizing. And two of those are puppies from our Born to Perform program, that this is their first full summer.
That the only thing they've ever ate is total canine.
Exactly.
You said something real important there, though, that you have puppies,
yep.
little puppies that are very, very small eating it, and your oldest dogs are doing okay on it?
The 15-year-old dog, he's fatter than a tick, and then we do have a dog named Tick that is fatter than a tick. All our dogs have done excellent. The only thing I can say about Total Canine is that you cannot... How some people feed a dog where they just throw a bucket of dog food out in a bowl and let them eat it, that you gotta give portions to Total Canine. They love it, they eat it, but you dang sure can't give them a bucket of it.
Okay, so self-feeding is probably not in the way.
No, because you know they love it so much. I mean, they'll clean their bowls and they'll regulate themselves out. You know, a lot of times when we're working, when we're traveling, they eat everything. And now they've been on vacation for the last 2 months. When we got off the road the end of September, you know, we went home to Arizona, and I've just given them the time off. And you know, some days if they're playing real hard, they eat it. If they're just laying around enjoying the sun, you know, they might eat half of it, and then the next day they clean it up, or you know, they get their regular portion. But it's not a automatic feed or self-serving feed, as you say.
And you're talking about, he's got quite a few dogs as well.
Well, yeah, they have a whole menagerie of dogs, and these are not high purebred dogs. They're rescue dogs, and like you heard him talk about, they get them from shelters and things, and it doesn't matter what the background or origin is, they have the ability to take them in and teach them these tricks and things for the show ring. And so they fill a real nice place in the dog world of making these dogs have a job, giving them a home and a job at the same time. Dogs love a job just like a horse. They want to do something.
They sure do.
And they want to please you.
Yep.
And so, but they covered on several things there. The attention span that they get when they train these dogs is improved. And just the stamina, the hair coat and everything, just like everybody else talks about. Is so important, and it's a lifestyle product.
You know, goats are becoming so popular in this country. Let's talk a little bit about Total Goat.
Look, Total Goat is an interesting thing that is increasing in popularity because the goat population is growing so much in the United States, and we're getting calls from all over the country about it, and questions about it. But Total Goat is a kind of a phenomenal product in the fact that it's so diverse in what it does. For if you have a show goat and a meat goat, it makes the best little meat goat that you can imagine, and the nicest, cleanest carcass and everything in the show for the show ring. And so that's one thing. But in the mama side, it is increasing the number of babies they have. The fertility aspect of this is so important because that's money in the bank if they have one more kid each time. And if they have two crops a year, well, that's quite a bit of money.
Yes.
And so the fertility side is good. And not only the fertility side, but we've had nannies that have had up to four babies and have fed all of them. They produce enough milk to feed those multiple births.
Wow.
Also, no runts. Just like in the deer world, where the deer on Total Deer, the does come in the fall with twins, and no runts because their milking is so heavy. Everybody gets a chance at the dinner plate.
And what's great about the fertility aspect, too, is it's across the board.
Yes.
With all species of animals.
Exactly. What I'm just talking about happens in all species, and we've talked about that many times.
Yeah, absolutely. Yep. We've heard from plenty of people.
Yep.
And you were talking about show goats. Hey,
yep.
It's time to start getting those goats ready right now.
That's right, for the next season.
Yep.
Yep.
And a lot of people are doing so. But let's hear Brian Doty's testimonial. He loves your product.
You bet. Brian, you've been using Total Goat for quite a while now, and you've related a few items over time of what you've seen in your goats. Tell me overall how the goats are doing with Total Goat.
The goats are doing good. You know, the crazy thing is their hooves. I have to trim their hooves a lot. So it's created more work for me, but they fill out. They also, we don't have one and two. We have three and four. So we have a lot more goats.
Okay. So, well, yeah. So you feel the fertility enhancement is definitely there that I always talk about?
Big time. It's there.
Okay. That's great. Now, I assume you have meat goats, not milk goats.
Yes, sir. And we kind of, some of them are just kind of low-end show goats for the kids in the area for their, you know, FFA stuff.
And you may be familiar with that voice. He's got a radio show, right?
Yes, On Air with Brian Doty.
On Air with Brian Doty, and he loves Total Goat. Now, we have so much more to talk about when it comes to all the animals that your Total Feeds products help, but we're going to talk about Total People Plus when we come back. We're going to stop here for a moment and take a quick break. We've talked about the beneficial ways that Total Feeds can impact your animals. When we come back, we're going to talk about how Total People Plus can give your body all the help it needs to perform at its maximum potential. And our phone lines are open. We want to hear from you tonight. Give us a call at 877-731-6777. Call in with your questions for Dr. Anderson. Stay with us. More Rural America Live with Total Feeds right after this. Welcome back to Rural America Live. I'm Christina Loren. Joining us tonight is the founder of Total Feeds, Dr. Harry Anderson. And remember, you're a big part of the show. We want to hear from you tonight. Call in with your questions for Dr. Anderson or even share your stories of success with the Total Feeds line of products. The number to call is 877-731-6733. Grab a pen and jot it down, 877-731-6733. We want to hear from you. Now, Dr. Anderson, your products aren't just for animals. You also have Total People Plus, which has helped thousands of people across the country, and it's growing rapidly in popularity.
It sure is. We're having a great time with Total People Plus, and the biggest excitement I get out of it is the stories I hear and all the people that we are helping. We can make a whole page full of a list of things that are benefits. But I do have a couple, three tonight that I'd like to share. Penny Gilly, you know, she helps me with this program. I'm on her show and she's been on this show. But she kind of shares some of these testimonials with us. But I'd really like to share a couple of them that she sent me this time. One is with Ron Boyer of Cross Plains, Tennessee. Ron is a diabetic. And he called to reorder Total People, and he told her how that his blood work has improved since being on the Total People Plus. And he started taking about 7 months ago, and he's feeling so much better. Thanks, Dr. Harry. I love that. No, but really, it's so gratifying to know that someone like that has a better quality of life and is less dependent on insulin.
Yes.
And they're less concerned about their day-to-day fluctuation in blood sugar. And I think he told her it had come down 50 points and he still has some more
wow.
to go. That's pretty dramatic.
Absolutely. And I mean, there's a lot of people who pay a lot of money for that insulin each and every week.
Absolutely. It's a big selling drug. And then Joe Hernandez from Odessa, Texas, he said he loves Total People Plus because he has suffered with bone spurs. Now, this one really baffles me, but it's not the only one I've gotten about this. He has had bone spurs in his feet for quite a while, and bone spurs make it very, very painful to walk. And usually there's only one way to get rid of them. They go in and they scrape them out or they do something like that. But he wanted to urge everyone to stay on this faithfully because he said he might have given up early on because it didn't happen overnight. Well, you can imagine changing the shape of a bone or something, how long it takes. Mm. But he said took it for long enough for it to kick in, and it's so much worth it. He is so glad to stay with it. They didn't give in too soon, and he really encourages people, if they're going to try Total People Plus, don't give it 2 weeks or 30 days. You've got to give it some time. And then the other one that I have is one that I had a lady call me about. She's Olivia Sundin. She's from Ohio. And Olivia is a person that had a shoulder injury. And she said that she takes four pills per day and her shoulder pain is about 95% gone.
Wow.
Then she goes on to tell that she had an injury, a strain injury at work a year ago, and she'd been doing physical therapy, which would helped and everything, but she got it up to about 60 to 75% of what she wanted as far as being able to work and do the things she wanted, until she got on Total People Plus, and all of a sudden, it 100%. She can do anything she wants. And she said now, and the thing is, Christina, she's only been on it 2 weeks.
My goodness.
And she said when, now she has a little twinge of that shoulder and pushes it a little too hard, about 30 seconds of kind of exercise, and it goes away, and she can go right back to what she was doing. So gratifying. It's just wonderful.
Oh, my gosh. You're giving these people their lives back.
Yes.
I love that. I mean, we have a caller who didn't want to actually go on the air, but she's wondering if it will help with gout, if Total People Plus can help with gout. Have you had any success stories there?
We have had stories about gout that the symptoms go away. Again, this is a gout and Crohn's and celiacs and things, they're autoimmune problems. Autoimmune problems typically are somewhat of an imbalance in the hormones of the body. If you give the body the right blood flow and the right critical nutrients, especially trace minerals and things, to start the reaction to create the hormones it needs, it will get better. And if your hormones are in balance,
yes,
then you don't have many problems. And yes, I think it will help the gout. I can't make a promise, but you just have to try it. But we've had stories about that.
It's interesting how when your body is off balance, it's really hard to tell what is causing it.
But
for one product to be able to align things the way that they should be, I mean, it's amazing. Why not try it?
We give it a buffet to choose from.
Yes, you do. And you just showed how everything works as well through the digestive system.
Yes.
And it's wonderful. You know what? You get a buffet of symptoms that you're helping.
That's right.
Of issues that you're helping people with. You're giving them back that quality of life. I mean, you talk about the person who had the spurs in their feet, and walking just to get to the bathroom would be difficult.
That's right.
You're helping people, and
you bet.
I think it's a beautiful thing. All right, we heard from Bert and Franny a little bit earlier on in the show about Total Canine, but they also use Total People Plus. Let's hear from them.
We're actually doing really awesome on it. We definitely have more energy. We've been working really hard on a new piece of property, and so it's nice to have the energy that we get from Total People Plus. The other thing with that is that seems to help lessen my hot flashes, and so I'm better off with taking the Total Human, and I noticed that we do have definitely better energy. We have to get our hair cut and do our nails a little bit more often because we tend to have really good growth with that also, so there's your added bonus points.
Well, now, you've been working hard. She said you've been working hard, getting a new place going and everything. And when you work hard, especially as we mature, sometimes we get sore muscles, sore joints and stuff. And do you feel that this has helped you kind of recover from those traumas you put yourself through?
Well, yeah, because if I'm not taking Total Human, because, you know, I'm a candidate for a hip replacement, and also we don't know if it's a total knee replacement or not, or just have it scoped, but with us work, you know, I've been in a lot of pain for the last couple of years, and I thought it was another injury, and Doc Trotter at Dodge City, we stopped by and see him, you know, for my annual or biannual visit, and he took x-rays and goes, well, no reason why you're limping. You know, you got bone on bone on your hip. So, you know, that's a project during the winter. But I'd sure hate to see what I'd feel like if I wasn't on Total Human, because, you know, I'm, you know, now at my age and all the injuries, you know, after 45 years of being a rodeo clown, bullfighter, barrel man, I have injuries now that are appearing that happened 15, 20 years ago. And if I'm not on it, boy, you know, you might as well just shoot me.
No, we won't shoot him.
No, not at all. But, I mean, he makes a good point.
Yes.
He's put his body through the ringer over the years, and
oh,
so your
yeah.
product's helping him.
Yeah.
And his wife talking about how the hair is growing.
Yeah,
oh, my goodness.
That.
Try it just for that.
Yes, there you go.
All right, world-renowned horse trainer Craig Cameron. He's got a show right here on RFD-TV. He's also benefited from Total People Plus. Let's hear what Craig has to say about Total People Plus.
you know, myself, Total People Plus, you know, you got me started on that. You know, I had a horse go over the top of me and hurt me, and actually broke my back in a couple places, hurt my leg. And you said that you had seen some great results, people with injuries, and you told me the dosage to take. I got on it immediately, and my orthopedic surgeon, who was thinking about operating on my back, asked me what I was taking, and I told him, and he said, man, this is fabulous. You do not need any type of surgery at all. And man, I'm back stronger than ever, doing my workouts and riding one horse after the other. I feel really great, and it's just part of my daily routine now.
Wow, that's Craig Cameron. And, you know, you look at that him in that video, he's so joyous, he's so happy.
He's always that way.
He just means what he's saying.
Though. That's right.
You know, he believes in your product, and it really helped him. Okay, we have a caller, Colleen from Illinois. You are joining us tonight. We appreciate it. Thank you so much. You're on with Dr. Anderson.
Hello.
Hi, Colleen.
Yes, I've been trying to get you and trying to get you. You never call back.
What can I help you with?
I tell you, I've got several things. I'm 84, and my legs are getting awfully weak. I can't seem to get out of a chair easy and all that anymore. And I'm crippled.
Okay. Well, it's hard to say what effect Total People Plus will have on someone like that because, yes, it does help blood flow in the legs and part of what happens is when we start getting problems like that, the nervous system isn't working quite right in those areas to stimulate the nerves to function like they're supposed to do. If we can increase the blood volume moving through them and get the nutrients there so they can have the reactions to make those muscles contract when they need to do the moves that you want to make, yes, it can help. I have people that tell me how that they have a little more strength and stamina, and that goes right back to the Total People or the Total Equine or any other product. Well, Total Equine is probably more shows it more, or the Total Canine, where those animals that are more athletic, they tend to have stronger muscles, and they do their muscles work a lot better with less soreness and less tiredness. So I would say it's worth a chance. I can't make you a promise, but it has a very good chance that it can help that situation.
Excellent. Thank you so much for the call, Colleen. We appreciate hearing from you in Illinois tonight. All right, we got to talk about Total Bull, a complete extruded product for bucking bulls. And how does that work?
Well, we try to get people to understand that it's worth for more than just bucking bulls. It started out that way, and yes, it does help them tremendously. But it's also helping just general use for cows, babies, for weaning calves, for growing calves, whatever you want, show animals. And one of the things that's very, very important too here is the fertility aspect again of the program, and then the immune system for weaning calves. And I have some comments from Matt and Angela Hatcher from Kansas, from Emporia, Kansas, because they have used this for some time now, and they are getting some great results. They talk about how they have switched all of their animals over last fall to grass pasture mineral and the Total Bull for their cows. Here's a very interesting thing. Their cows ate one half as much mineral through the winter. Huh. Now, my mineral is expensive, but they ate half as much, which didn't cost them any more money, but they got great results because they said they weaned and their calves, they cut their bulls, which is pretty traumatic, and usually they have some health problems. They have to treat calves with antibiotics and things. This year they had zero sick calves.
Wow.
She said that's very almost unheard of. And so they usually doctor some, but their hair coats look good. Their health is stellar. I like that word stellar. That means it all, right?
Absolutely.
And they're so excited about it.
You know what's great is that we had a tremendous winter And so to hear that none of the calves got sick is amazing. Right. What a testimonial. Yeah.
And then we have one from Brandon Fields. He's a bucking bull breeder. And he said that he saw a difference in his bulls the first month he started using this program. And you see it in the muscling. They start to muscle up and they get kind of a good hair coat and shine on them. They started showing more definition. That's what he's talking about, muscling. And they're while staying on free choice hay. He also weaned his bulls, and they're coming to the bunks running and ready to eat. He said they look great. And that's very important when you're weaning calves. Yes. You want them to be aggressive at the feed bunk, because that's one of the problems you have when you wean calves, is they don't know how to eat, they don't want to eat, so you have to coax them and teach them. And he didn't have to.
Takes time as well away from the rancher. All right, Craig Cameron also uses Total Bull. Let's hear from him.
I've always been in the cattle business, so I got them feeding the Total Bull, and I've raised some heifers this year out of my cattle, and they have eaten exclusively from the time I weaned them up to now, where they are bred heifers now, which will be calving coming at the turn of the year. Man, they look like show cattle, and I'm not feeding them excessively or anything. They're out on pasture, and they look super. And I tell you what, I think they're going to have no trouble calving because they're just healthy. So really had good luck. And of course, my older cattle as well, we bring them up, every few days, and we put out some sacks of the Total Bull. Man, they love it. They lap it up. And I tell you what, man, do they look good. And they are raising this year. I've been in the cow business my whole life. Those were the heaviest calves I've ever raised this year. Yeah. Okay.
And so the calves have gotten to eat some Total Bull while they were with mom.
Oh, absolutely. And it doesn't take them long to get on it, too. And they come right up to those troughs. We have concrete troughs that we feed them in. And I mean, they're not very old before they're dipping their head in there and they're learning to eat. And of course, that helps when we wean them as well. They already know how to eat. And I'll tell you what, really puts them on their feet. And these cattle are healthy and they're really weaning us some big cattle and making us some money.
That you don't have those weaning problems that you can have if they don't know how to eat?
You know what? That's exactly right. You don't go through this process. I'm not having to feed medicated feeds or any of that type of stuff. I just stick with the Total Bull. They know what it is. They're on it immediately. And I tell you what, the weaning process gets very simple. And I tell you what, they start putting on the weight and they look great.
They look great and you're making them some money.
Yeah, I like that last part.
Me too. Yeah. All right, we are getting ready to wrap up the show, but you are always on the move, which is great because a lot of people get to meet you in person. Where are you headed next?
Well, we've got some things coming up. We're going to be in Madison, Wisconsin at the Midwest Horse Fair. Margaret and I always enjoy that because we see a lot of great people there. At the same time, Eric's going to be in Columbus, Ohio at the Equine Affair there. That's usually quite a big show, not as big as Madison, but it's a pretty good show. And then the Western Heritage Classic, there we're going to be in the Bit and Spur show. Ooh. And also we're going to have two locations this year because we are sponsoring Craig Cameron to come and do clinics during the Western Heritage. So folks, you want to come out and see this guy work because he's good. And he puts on a great show as well as teaches people. And we're proud to be there with him and help be the sponsor. And then a new show this year is the North Dakota Horse Expo in Minot, the very last weekend of May, the end of May and the first 2 days of June. We're going to be there for the first time. Then we come back on the air.
Can't wait for that.
I can't either.
Neither can our viewers, judging by the feedback that we get every time you're on. I just love your company so much. Before we go, I want to remind people about your YouTube page because you just have a wealth of resources there.
Our YouTube has, Corey told me the other day that we have 235 videos on YouTube where people can go and learn and get their questions answered. And I kind of tell people, if you can't find an answer to the question you're looking for on there, you're probably not trying real hard. So go to that YouTube of ours and find what you want.
Okay, absolutely. Now remember, if you are interested in any of the products that we told you about tonight, it's easy to find out more about Total Feeds. All you got to do is call Dr. Anderson directly. His number is 620-272-1065. I'm going to give it to you one more time. 620-272-1065. You can also visit TotalFeeds.com to see the complete line of products. Thanks for joining us. Good night from Rural America's Most Important Network.